Hi, in this learning bite, we're going to take a look at the backup wizard in Windows Small Business Server 2011 standard. So we'll start out here in the SBS console and go up to the Backup and Server Storage tab. And here we can see that the server has not yet been configured for backup. So what we're going to do is in the task pane, which you'll see throughout the console under the backup tasks, we'll go ahead and configure server backup. This initiates the SBS 2011 backup wizard, which will walk us through all of the steps that are required in order to protect the server using a external backup destination. So again, we're using hard disk-based backup as opposed to tape backup, as was done in previous versions of Windows Server and SBS around the 2003 timeframe. So at the beginning of the wizard, like all the wizards in the SBS environment, we have a getting started page where you can get a quick overview of the steps of the wizard, as well as get additional information about what is going to be performed during the wizard. So we'll go ahead and click next. And then at this point, as you have connected external hard drives to your server, either USB connections, FireWire, what have you, you would see the list of the available backup destinations here. You can also use internal backup disks, but this is less common in a production environment. In my demo environment, we're going to go ahead and check that so we can see the drives that I have available. So I'm going to select Disk 2 here. We're going to use that as my backup destination. Go ahead and click Next to select that. Now, one of the things that you should really keep in mind, and I highly recommend, is to label both the physical drive as well as provide a label here in the wizard so that you can match up the two when you're trying to do restores. So backup is all well and good, but we really want to be able to restore our data, and it's very, very helpful to be able to identify the actual physical media when you're running through the restore wizards. So this is just a place where we can label that. Go ahead and click Next. And then we can select which drives are going to be backed up as part of this wizard. So for now, we only have the system disk. We have the system reserved partition, and that is created automatically when we are installing SBS. And then we also have the C drive, which has all of the data for the server at this point. So if you see additional hard drives, or if you've added additional hard drives for data storage, then you would see those here as well. If you do have other drives beyond the system drive, then you can choose whether to include those in the backup or not by simply checking or unchecking the box. Here you can see that the choices that we have right now are grayed out because these have to be selected to protect the server. So let's go ahead and click Next. At this point, we can select a schedule. Now again, because we are backing up to disk as opposed to backing up to tape, the backup happens much, much more quickly than using these previous technologies. So by default, we're actually going to backup twice a day. The impact to the end user's productivity is very minimal as the backup runs. It takes a while to run the first backup to a backup destination because all of the blocks from the server are going to be put onto that new backup destination. But as that destination is used for additional backups, only changed blocks need to be written. So it's much, much quicker than you're basically getting an incremental backup each time. When you go to do the restore, the backup database that's contained on the backup destination will know which blocks comprise any file, folder, and so on for any given date. So you simply choose the date that you want your data to be restored to, and all of the appropriate blocks that make up those files will then be pulled from that backup destination. So you kind of get the best of both worlds where you have the very quick incremental type of backup operation, and yet you have a much more simplified restore capability. Now, if you wanted to, you can choose a custom schedule. You could back up many times throughout the day. This, again, is going to be just basically as appropriate for your particular environment. So let's go ahead and click Next. At this point, we'll just confirm the details from the backup wizard and go ahead and click Configure. So we get a quick warning here that we are about to format the drive that we selected for our backup destination. We'll go ahead and click Yes on that. And off we go with configuring the server backup wizard. So it's really that easy to configure backup for your SBS 2011 standard server, and I hope you'll join us for future Learning Byte sessions.